Women's basketball head coach Jamie Craighead after the Spartans fell to CSUN 76-59. Coach, can you start us off with an opening statement?
Just didn't feel like we competed for the first 30 minutes of the game. We had our moments, but it was really tough because we couldn't score and we couldn't get a stop. We forced 29 turnovers. That was good. But the rebounding margin and the second chances that we gave up, I mean, we're shooting almost a higher three-point percentage than we can from the free throw line. So that's never going to be good.
It looked like in the first half, Fluker, your defense did a pretty good job on her. She thinks she had 9 points and fewer than 10 rebounds.
Mm-hmm.
It looked like they were fronting and getting some help on the backside in the second half. They just lobbed that in there, and they really took over on the boards.
Yeah, I mean, when you have young post players, the fact that we could get them to front was great. But then there's always a counter to what you do defensively. And so it's sort of like a defensive back on a receiver. You can't lose contact, and if you try and make a play before when the ball's at its peak, it's going to end up in her hands. So we tried to work through that a little bit. You know, I was calling timeouts just to teach them how to play lob defense over the top there. But you could do it right 5 times and then we'll do it wrong 5 times because it's just the consistency and the reps and being in those positions. And that's the biggest post player we've played in a long time. Probably the biggest post player we'll see all year, to be honest. I know Oregon State has some size, but this kid's 6'4" and she's a load. She was tough to handle. And I thought we just kind of broke away from the game plan because they hit a couple threes and then it makes our kids freak out and start running at people when you play the percentages and, you know, maybe they hit a few threes, but we'd rather them hit threes than lob inside, and we just gave up that game plan.
And I mean, the team that comes in shooting 24% from the three-point range, they knock down 3 or 4 early on. Do their shoulders go down and yours, you know, kind of get tense?
You would hope not, because we're always going to hit more threes than the other team. As poorly as we shot tonight and played, we still hit more, didn't we? So one less. So the three-point line doesn't hurt you, and it's just those points in the paint and the second chances and not boxing out on those long shots. And then we took some crazy shots offensively. We're 1-on-5 when we just need to execute and run our motion and just let it touch a few people's hands and turn the corner and get a layup instead of shooting floaters from the free throw line.
But also looked at times you were getting into the lane, you were getting the shots at the rim, and nothing was falling down.
But they're not real shots at the rim if you're trying to shoot floaters every time. And it's, you got to turn the corner. Like, you got to be so tough and so aggressive that as soon as you pull up for the floater, the defender's right back in front of you. And I just didn't think we squeezed the defense hard enough tonight. You know, I know Taylor's kind of battling a little bit of an injury right now, and that's never good, you know, with her, because it's hard. She's an explosive player, likes to get to the paint. She's just not moving that well today. So hopefully we can get her right and get her back going.
Andrew?
Yeah, so, Coach, speaking of running at people, I noticed that CSUN had a lot of speed, and some of their players were dribbling past San Jose State players who were leaping up trying to play defense, and they were out-hustling us on the rebounds. So, talk about how you dealt with a pretty fast CSUN team today.
Well, if you're talking about our players jumping in the air, we run a press that's running and jump. Mm-hmm. The problem is that the jumper wasn't communicating with the person on the ball that they were jumping, and you should get a runoff.
Right.
So we were getting caught where we had two on the ball, and that's really what hurt us. If you're running off, the jump makes you have to throw the ball in the air, and you should be there on the catch. The rebounds, it was just bad. I mean, we let people get inside. Guards were getting rebounds. The post was getting rebounds. The lobs, the putbacks. You know, but 38 points in the paint, we've given up a lot more than that before. If we could just got something going offensively tonight, we're 20 of 62. You know, we just needed to be able to put more balls in the basket. I mean, the 29 turnovers is great. But we just didn't get up enough shots for us. When we get 29 turnovers for opponent, we should have shot the ball at least 80 or 90 times, but we didn't convert.
Any pauses? I mean, Alexis Harris comes out.
We shot 30 free throws. Sorry.
I'm sorry. Career high, 8 points, 5 mm-hmm. rebounds. She showed you a little something tonight. Alexis in there fighting.
Yeah. She was fighting. We just... Fighting only matters when you're in the game, and a part of it is, you know, we got to a place where we weren't in the game, and because of it, you can run around and play hard now, but you should have played hard in the first 20 minutes, 30 minutes, and I just see some things still where, you know, as a sophomore, we have to move on. Like, we have to understand when you can help, when you can't help. So I just expect that every year someone's going to get better and better. So she's got to, you know, clean it up on the defensive end.
What do you have to do offensively to stay in these games early on? You're losing the scoring battle in the first period a lot.
I mean, we got to hit shots. I mean, we had plenty of shots, you know, and 30 free throws. Like, if you're shooting 13 of 30 from the free throw line, I don't know how to help you. It's an unguarded shot from 15 feet, and we shoot free throws every day in practice, every single day, because we know how much the payoff is, that it's the highest percentage shot. Well, it's not for us. We shoot three-pointers better than we shoot free throws. So, I mean, 13 of 30, like, that's just baffling.
Yes, Coach. I also saw that Wilson during the third quarter got both a personal foul combined with a technical, and because you reached five fouls, you got disqualified from the game. Would you be able to explain how she got the technical?
I think she had some choice words for the official, is what the official told me. You know, she thinks that when she's talking to her teammates, she can say whatever, but if the ref can hear it, then they can take it however they want to take it. And ultimately, she's got to fix that stuff. We can't have somebody taken out of the game because they can't control their emotions. She's young and she's got to get better. That's number two. So there's, you know, some consequences for that for us, that we hope, you know, by giving her some consequences, she can learn from that experience. And I know her teammates want her on the court, and she's got to be able to, you know, control her attitude, because not every call is going to go our way. And we know that, you know, you just got to play through it.
Last one, Andrew.
Another question. Every game this year, the turnovers have been in double figures, but this game tonight, if there was any positive, season low 9 turnovers. What do you think of the ball handling?
You know what's funny about that? The reason why there's only 9 turnovers is we're going slow. And if you like this outcome, then we can continue to go slow and we'll get this outcome. 76-59, because we're not big enough to play in a half-court game. We're going to turn the ball over sometimes, pushing and playing as fast as possible. And, you know, I think if we have about 15 turnovers, we can live with that. 15 turnovers we can live with. I thought that how slow the game was played and just not really. And when you don't pass the ball, you're not going to turn it over. If one person dribbles it the whole time, it's harder to turn it over. So there's just lots of things that we look at that are different from a typical stat sheet. And I think that for us, the pace just wasn't there offensively. But I thought that it was tremendous that we could get them to turn the ball over 29 times. We just got to do something with those 29 turnovers.
Coach, thank you very much. Good luck at Oregon State.
Thank you.